Let's check out these pizzas, shall we? Okay. We've got a minute or two left.
Wait, how long do they take to cook that?
Like 3 or 4 minutes.
No way. Yeah, this oven's about 375.
God. No wonder it's called Express.
Not pizza leisurely, is it? Express. Hi, I'm Mike, and you're watching Behind the Bass. Today, we are very excited to be joined by the new pop sensation, Elle Devine. No stranger to the Radio 1 playlist, her music has resonated with people from all around the world, and this year, she's playing some of the biggest, most exciting festival stages. But is there a bigger or more exciting stage than the Pizza Express kitchen? I doubt it. Elle Devine, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
How
for
you
having
feeling?
Me.
Are you confident about your pizza making skills today?
Yeah, I'm really hungry. So
fantastic. Well, let's get stuck in there. And then we're going to do tip to our nicely manicured fingers.
Yes.
And push slowly down around the edge of our dough like that. Make it nice and flat. Perfect. And you're going to work your way up the middle. Like that.
Oh,
that's what
that was nice, wasn't it? Little fart. Little pizza fart.
Keep repeating that process all the way around. Pizza fart is what we want. Right, we're going to get straight in with it. Charlie XCX dubbed you the mother future of pop.
Yeah, she
you've
did.
Got famous fans in Dua Lipa and Lewis Capaldi. How does it feel to have praise from those people, those figures in music at the moment?
Yeah, it's pretty mad. I don't know what they're on about, really. No, it's really cool. I look up to those people a lot. So, see this, I've already got flour all over.
That's right. You're not making enough, enough job, I say.
But yeah, it's really cool, man. I look up to all those people, and for them to have like, even heard my music and know who I am is absolutely mental.
Are you the motherfucking future of pop?
I don't know, she said that quite a few years ago now, so we'll I don't know.
You're the present.
She was wrong, yeah, no. Yeah, hopefully, we'll see, still finding that out.
That's interesting you say that, because I was wondering about an album. So obviously in the world now with singles and playlists and things like that, is the sort of the traditional 12-track LP as important a milestone for an up-and-coming artist like yourself?
I think so. Definitely after, like, you know, I've done the whole thing of, you know, I've tried out loads of different genres, put my finger in loads of different pies and stuff, and now I think I'm ready to do, like, you know, a body of work that all is, like, really glued together.
As is tradition on the show, we need to make sure that our pizzas have been
chucked
up in the air. Are you feeling brave enough to do that today?
I think so. What, is there a technique?
I sort of lay my hands sort of like this, and then lay the dough on top, and then I'm just gonna, like, spin like that. Nice, one-handed.
That's all right.
That's a pretty advanced technique to do a one-handed one. How high do you reckon you get? Good catch.
Yay.
Nicely done. All right, so I've got a pan here. You've got a pan just there. What you want to do is just drop your dough in the pan like that. And then lift with my right hand.
Got you. Okay.
And stretch it out till it fits the pan like that. I know you've said in the past that songwriting...
feels really thin. I'm sorry.
Songwriting helps you understand yourself. Has that always been the case?
Yeah, 100%. I think at the time, you don't really... it's not really a conscious thing. And then, like, I'll look back, like... so say this kind of album I've been writing for the past year, like I look back at that now and I'm like, whoa, that really has summed up the way that I've felt for this past year and how I felt about myself. So I think, which can be really useful. Save some money on therapy and just write songs instead.
Well, it can be like a therapy for a lot of people.
Yeah, totally.
What were those sort of first songs that you wrote like? What were they about?
Well, the first song I ever released was called Schoolgirls, which was about school.
Right.
So
clever title.
Which is about like girls at school and stuff and like bitchiness. But I guess I've always been kind of like writing about what's been going on in my life and stuff. So yeah.
So this is our Italian tomato dip.
Wow.
Specially made at Pizza Express. Beautiful, and that can go back in the tin when you're done with it. So we can do some toppings as well. And the prawns are just here. However you feel best present yourself through the medium of pizza. So the song you're going to be playing for us today, Daughter.
Yes.
Obviously a very honest, very personal song.
Yeah.
Can you tell us a little bit about what it's about and why you think it impacted and resonated with so many people so much?
So I wrote that song, I wrote it probably about like 4 years ago now, and I wrote it about my first relationship when I was around 17, and it was the first time I'd ever been with a girl and finally like I just came out and I could finally express like my sexuality and like fully be myself and I got in a relationship with someone and it was amazing. It was just like everything that love should be, but her mum was like really not cool with it when we told her, and she like kept us apart, and it was pretty mental and stuff. But I mean, everything's in the song, you know. You can go listen to the song and it tells you the story, but I think it resonated with people so much. Because I don't think at the time as well there was that many stories like that being told mm-hmm. in pop music. I think like every year, you know, there's like new amazing queer artists who are telling those stories and who have those narratives. But I think then it was kind of on the cusp of like there still wasn't that many songs talking mm-hmm. about that kind of thing. And I just wanted to write the song that I wish I had when I was like 15, 16, you know?
Nice, yeah.
That's the one that everyone reaches out to me about. Like everyone sends me DMs and stuff and like, you helped me on my coming out journey and stuff. And
nice.
So that's amazing. It means so much to me.
What's that like when people reach out to you and have, because they obviously, and they trust you there. What's that like to have that kind of trust in your audience?
They shouldn't trust me. I'm pretty batshit. But it's lush. I love it, man. I love the connection that I have with my fans and the people that come see my shows. That honestly, it is just like an extension of like my mates.
Should we get our prawns on?
Yeah, let's do it.
I think you could probably do about 5 or 6. You don't want to do 2.
Maybe. Yeah.
So obviously you get a lot of positive feedback, but with that inevitably comes some negative feedback. You talk about the school run dads quite a lot, and particularly that's your song Girls Like Sex. Because obviously you've had a really nice positive, that's nice to get positive feedback. What's it like to get sort of a negative sort of backlash?
Well, lots of reasons. I mean, that's kind of the whole reason that I, you know, put out the song, because apparently people can handle like misogyny on the radio. Like at the time, I remember when I put that song out, there was like, and listen, I'm not like bashing anyone here, but you know, there was like, when I put that song out on the radio at the same time, was that you can't make a wife out of a hoe song. And I'm just like,
super
no one's saying
song.
All about that song. Yeah. And then it's like all these dads are like on Twitter saying that I'm a paedophile because my song's getting played at 9 a.m. on school run. And it's like, it wasn't even that explicit really. Like it,
I think the title alone was enough to rile people up.
So I don't know. It was, but it was great. And that's like, I was so buzzing that Radio 1 did that because, you know, they didn't have to do that. They probably knew they would have got a bit of backlash from that song, and they really like championed it, and Greg James like made it his tune of the week, and I was super buzzing with that.
Fantastic.
It was great.
So black pepper oregano, just a nice, generous
nice
helping across there. Beautiful.
Oh gosh, I went a bit heavy on that. It's a peppery slice.
Peppery slice. You can have that one. Yeah, bit of oregano as well. Delicious. And it wouldn't be the garlic prawn pizza without some garlic oil. The first CD you got was Wheatus' Teenage Dirtbag, is that
right?
Yeah,
it was, yeah.
Do you want to put some of that on there?
Lush.
What other sort of influential kind of albums from those times?
I was a little bit into like more of my punkier stuff, like all my dad's music.
If you were an artist and you're watching this, what sort of some advice that you would like to give those people? Sort of up and coming in this climate we're in now.
What advice would I give? I think just like, I know it sounds daft, but like make sure you know like who you are and like really what you want to make. I think like go out and do all those things that like help you discover that as well. Like listen to as much music as you can and really find out what you like, and try out like loads of different styles until you find out what you really like making, and because that's what's going to set you apart. You just need to like carve out a space for yourself and, you know, listen to your music against your peers and against like stuff that you like, and find out how you can stick out. I think that's what it's all about these days,
isn't
it? Yeah.
Should we get these in the oven?
Yeah, definitely.
Excellent. Don't touch it because it's really hot.
Okay.
What we're going to do is kind of push it in like that.
Nice.
While that's cooking, I've got a sort of quick fire round for you. So your name's El Devine, not your real name. It's a stage name. It's a moniker.
It is.
I'm going to go through a few famous people whose name isn't their stage name.
And I need to guess their name.
And I'm going to give you two options, and you're going to tell me which one you think is the correct one. Elton John, is he Peter R. Talbot or Reginald Dwight?
Reginald Dwight.
That's correct. FK Twigs, Anna Peebles or Talia Barnett?
I don't know. First one?
Anna Peebles.
Yeah.
Talia Barnett.
Anna? No.
Incorrect.
Sorry, I love her as well. That's
Bruno Mars, Peter Hernandez or Jason Andre?
Let's go Peter.
Fantastic guess. And apparently his middle name's Gene.
Gene, nice. He said that actually.
Lana Del Rey, Svetlana Ivanko or Elizabeth Grant?
Elizabeth Grant.
It's Elizabeth Grant, yeah. I think that's pretty well known. And Snoop Dogg, Cordoza Calvin Broadus Jr. or Lord Andvar Princeton II?
Lord
Andvar Princeton II.
He's not a lord, is he?
Could be. Is he Cordoza Calvin Broadus Jr.?
Yeah,
is he?
I'm going to say that.
Well, then that's right.
Yeah.
Was that 4 out of 5?
I mean, yeah, that's pretty good, you know, that's all right.
Thank
Sorry, Twigs, I love you, but don't know your name.
Let's check out these pizzas, shall we?
Wow.
They look pretty good to me, so yeah, get right underneath it. And pull it out. gently on the shelf.
Done it.
Nicely done. So that's pretty good.
Hey.
There's a plate for you.
I'm going to get a pizza over me. That's so cool.
You're pretty good. Whoa,
oh,
delicious.
It's oily. I love it.
Let's put the peel back on top of the oven.
Cheers, mate.
We'll do our finishing touches, but they're nice to get a nice...
It smells so good. I wish you could smell it.
Bit of parsley. So let's slice these up.
Slice and dice.
Oh, you've got to commit to the slice. That's what I always say.
Yeah.
Straight through, nicely done. And then we've got a bit of a special treat for you today because in honour of you, you know, you've had to change your name because of a certain type of person that's also got the same name as you. We've got a porn star martini.
Well, she doesn't actually have the same name as me. That's not actually a... Whoa!
She's jacked your name, hasn't she?
Look at that.
We've got a porn star martini. In honour of you, brand new Pizza Express menu. Ah.
Cheers, man.
That is good.
It's really good.
You can have a sip as well.
Mm-hmm. You don't even put that in there.
I think you can ask me.
Oh, I don't know. I've never had them.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Fantastic. Oh, it's good.
Her love for soft lips and rosy cheeks, the only secret that she would keep till I saw her and she saw me. Every day meeting on the sly, told her friends and we told you lies, cause the world wasn't on our side, no. Well, it's hard enough losing our innocence, believe me, it's not easy, no. So say your worst, trust me, your ignorance don't faze me. She's my baby girl. It goes against everything that you taught her, but I'm sorry, miss, I'm in love with your daughter. Said what about kids, all the hopes I had for her. Well, I'm sorry, miss, I'm in love with your daughter. I can't believe you would break her heart just to make sure that we're apart. Not your life, but you'll get what you want. And here's the part where we run away, me and her take the great escape. I don't care about a thing you say now. Well, it's hard enough losing our innocence, believe me, it's not easy. So say your worst, trust me, your ignorance don't faze me. She's my baby girl. It goes against everything that you taught her, but I'm sorry, miss, I'm in love with your daughter. Said what about kids, all the hopes I had for her. Girl, I'm sorry, I'm sorry, miss, I'm in love with your daughter. I know that this ain't what you really wanted, but I'm sorry, miss, I'm in love with your daughter. It goes against everything that you taught her, but I'm sorry, miss, I'm in love with your daughter. Said what?